It's pretty much common knowledge now that the whole Sims community agrees that we have way, way too many stuff packs. 18 to be exact. That's $180. Do you know what I could buy with $180? 45. 4 for $4 meals from Wendy's. Okay, it's my weakness. A small nugget, a small fry, a small hamburger, and a small drink for $4. Okay, I need to stop. Oh my god, I am hungry. But because of this dilemma, we're pretty much getting stuff packs thrown at our faces. And when you have too much of one thing, you kind of forget what to do with it and kind of just, you get bored. Well, not so fast, baby girl. I got the answers. I have compiled a bunch of different ideas and tips for each separate stuff pack, and it took me a little bit. It really did. There's just so many. God damn it. EA, why? Why, why, why? All right, now that I've thrown that absolutely deserved shade, I'm going to start all the way with the first stuff pack, and that was luxury party stuff. Now, obviously, there may be fewer or more ideas for a specific stuff pack than others, just because some of them are just kind of vague and don't really offer any like way for me to implement concrete gameplay. But one thing I did notice with luxury party is that all of the build mode items especially were really like, they look like wedding-esque, especially the like chocolate fountain that they added into the pack. You could also build like a really fancy nightclub or lounge and put the chocolate fountain in it. I just love, I rarely play with the fountain, and I just often forget that it exists. So but yeah, there are actually, I think, a few mods out there, or maybe just one, that actually allow your Sims to have the event planner career. So you can definitely implement mods into some of these tips as well. So have your Sim be an event planner and then make your own kind of like wedding venue with all of these items, because they really fit well with the wedding kind of theme. And just rent it out. You can always role play, invite some Sims over, and just kind of I don't know, kind of make believe that they get married and like charge them and add some money to your bank account. I mean, this pack, not a lot to do with it, but it does have some potential. Okay, it was the first stuff pack. We can let it slide. Next up, we have Perfect Patio, which was actually a pretty good step up from Luxury Party, I have to say. It is one of the really good packs for outdoor barbecues and hot tub nights. All the outdoor furniture is really cool. I've never had like patio furniture like that. So I just personally love this stuff pack. It's one of my favorites. So really great for outdoor barbecues or even outdoor dinner nights. And especially with the hot tubs, you can have your family come over, family or friends, and just chill in the hot tub. I never had a hot tub either, so I would take advantage of this if I had one. Also, this pack came with aprons, like apron outfits for both genders. So you can definitely use these for like going out to a baking class or a cooking class, especially for you console players. I know you can't download CC. Oh, I actually really do hope that this video is of much use to you as well. Cool Kitchen also has some aprons if you want to use those instead of the Perfect Patio ones. And let's not forget the oh so famous ice cream maker. I love having like ice cream days during the summer. If you have seasons, or even if you don't, you can still do this. Letting my kids have a few cups of ice cream. You can also place down or have your Sims even open up their own ice cream shop. So that could go with dine in. So many ice cream flavors to choose from. This is also one of my favorite packs just because of the ice cream maker, because we all love ice cream. By the way, if you haven't seen my functional ice cream truck mod, check it out. Okay, it's up here. All in all, a pretty cool pack. I love the Create a Sim items as well. Nothing much to do, but even if you think you have nothing to do with the pack, there is always something. If you don't have seasons, you can still use spooky stuff. And if you have seasons, that's even better. But if you don't have seasons, you can still have a Halloween or a spooky day with this pack, which is what I genuinely love about packs like these that add this to the game, where you don't necessarily need the other pack. And don't worry if you don't have paranormal stuff, because you could definitely make your own makeshift haunted house out of the build mode items with this pack. You could also make a fall festival, which is something I really like to do with my families, especially with the pumpkin carving station. I'm not sure why that came with spooky stuff and not seasons, but nevertheless, I love this pack just for the fact that you can carve pumpkins, and I kind of forget to do that every single spooky day season in my game, but I love carving pumpkins. You could have your kids carve pumpkins and put them out in front of the house and light them and just celebrate spooky day. There's also actually a little bowl of candy that you get with the pack that you can actually pull for tricks or treats. You could put that down at your spooky day party, at your fall festival if you make one, at your haunted house if you make one. Definitely lots of possibilities with this pack when it comes to the Halloween theme. Movie Hangout is amazing. I also really love this pack. It's just my weakness. Like, I love having movie nights at home with my Sims, making snacks, not just popcorn, but making like chips and salsa that the game already has, or chocolate chip cookies, like snacks like that. You can place or build your own movie theaters and take your Sims out on date nights, or you can actually take your kids out and go spend time with them at the movies and watch like one of the movies for like younger kids. I forgot what it was called, but you know the one. And a while ago with spooky stuff, when we were talking about festivals, I just thought it was a good idea to have like a popcorn maker at your seasonal festivals, and have there be popcorn to give out to everybody, or kettle corn. Movie Hangout is definitely one of the good ones. Romantic Garden doesn't really have that much gameplay aspects to it. It is definitely similar to Luxury Party in the sense that you could also use this pack to become like a wedding planner or an event host, especially with all the beautiful build items. It's really pretty, especially for like the rustic barn kind of theme for weddings. It's also just really good for scenery builds in general. If you want to build like a pretty pond or like a wishing well lot or something, it would be really good for that. Like I said, I'm not a builder. I'm a gameplay enthusiast. I actually love kids' room stuff because of the puppet show thing. One of my favorite things to do with my kids in The Sims 4 is to actually like host puppet plays or puppet shows like at a nearby park and invite family and friends. I just think it's so freaking cute. I also really like the void critter aspects to it, so you could definitely have your kids create like a void critter club. You could have them collect void critter cards just like Pokemon cards pretty much. I mean, if you have seasons and it's Winterfest, you could gift your kids like those void critter card packs and host tournaments with other kids. It's just so cute. It's just so cute. Backyard Stuff is another really good pack for barbecue parties, outdoor parties, especially with the water slides and the drink trays during the summertime. You could also add those water slides to pool lots and kind of create like a water park if you wanted to. I also really, really love the wind chimes in this pack. It just creates a lot of realism because a lot of people have wind chimes. I don't. I wish I did, but the wind chimes in the game, all of them sound really, really pretty, and a lot of houses do have them, so it's pretty realistic. With Vintage Glamour, the build mode items don't just have to be for like super rich and luxurious Sims. Some of the contemporary pieces in the pack really work for a lot of Sims, especially some of the lamps that they have, and they actually in the pack have a vanity, which you can use to gift your teen Sims for Christmas or even your child Sim. The pack did come with the ability to hire a butler, and if you do have rich Sims, don't always use a butler for them. You know, you can if they're like really rich and snobby, but for rich Sims who are more on the humble side, they don't have to have a butler. They could just have a maid or just clean the damn house themselves. I mean, come on. Oh, guys, I am so sorry. There's a lot of stuff packs. I underestimated it, so I might have to talk about the rest in a very rush tone. Next up is Bowling Night Stuff, and like the name of the pack says, you should definitely host bowling nights with your friends or your family. You could also actually create a bowling club and host your own tournaments with your own like teams. The cast items are really good for this. They have a lot of like bowling shirts, and we all know most teens and children love to go bowling, so let them. Don't just keep them in the house all day doing homework, swinging on those sad swings, that sad swing set in your backyard. Let them go out and bowl and just have fun. Do create or place down your own arcades too. I love taking my Sims out to arcades. With Fitness Stuff, you can have your Sim have kind of like their own rock climbing hobby. I know a lot of people do actually like to go rock climbing as their hobby. I couldn't, but They do them, you do you. You can also build or add like your own rock climbing gym. So it is a gym lot, but solely for rock climbing. So for your Sims who do have that rock climbing hobby, they have a place where they can go and kind of train and practice. Don't just use the earbuds they give you when your Sim is working out. Use it when they're reading, or if you have nifty knitting, when they're knitting, and just whenever they have the time, especially when they're reading too, because I know a lot of us like to listen to music, soft music while we're reading, or just kind of pretend they're listening to an audiobook. I thought that was something really cool. With toddler stuff, you can create a brand new playground with all of the new equipment and toys and stuff like that that comes with the pack. You could create like a fun party house like Chuck E. Cheese. Do you guys remember Chuck E. Cheese? I was obsessed with Chuck E. Cheese. And add the ball pit to it. We love the ball pit. And add some slides and stuff like that. Just kind of like a party house for your little tots to go to and have a birthday party or something. Some of the cast items I saw were actually really good for costumes, like Halloween costumes. I saw like a bee shirt, and then I saw a bear hoodie, which I just thought was really cute. Host your own laundry service with Laundry Day. I know I keep repeating it, but a lot of this stuff does just have to do with role playing and using your imagination, but you could set up like a laundry room in your own house and charge other Sims to do their laundry at your house. You can also build or place a laundromat, and don't just always use the laundry machines. Use the water bucket and the clotheslines, because sometimes people just prefer that, or they just cannot afford washing machines, which is totally okay. They just prefer to go more of the natural route with the kind of washer bucket and the clothesline. So use the machines or the clotheslines accordingly to your Sim's personality. It could also go with eco lifestyle too. You could go the natural route and contribute to your community's eco footprint. My first effing pet. You know, this pack, it was pretty controversial, and it still remains one of the most controversial ones for obvious reasons. But for this pack, I would just say to try to take care of all the different little pets that we get. I have a habit of sticking to like the turtle, I think, and just doing the turtle all the time because I just love turtles. But just try to take care of all of them. And with the pet clothing that comes in the cast for the pack, you can use those for costumes, like for like spooky day costumes or something. You can dress up your cats or dogs in little spooky day costume. But yeah, that's all the pack is good for. I will not apologize. Obviously, with Moschino Stuff Pack, you can become a freelance photographer. You can either host your business at home, or you can build or place down your own personal photo studio. I also love to take family photos with the pack and hang them up on the walls and like combine them all and have like a family picture wall. I don't know what I'm saying. You get what I'm saying, but it's really cute. I actually have one of those in my current save right now with Antonia, and I will put that right here. I really love this idea. With tiny living, you can create your own tiny small like townhouses or apartments, because some of them are really small, especially the ones not just in America. I've seen in England, they are really, really close together and really, really tiny. You can rent out the rooms in those small townhouses and utilize the Murphy beds. I love the Murphy beds. Pair this pack with eco lifestyle and you have the perfect minimalistic life. Nifty knitting also goes really well with city living. If you have city living, don't just use Plopsy to sell your creations that your Sims have knitted. You can use the sales table from city living and have a yard sale right in front of your house with all the things that your Sims have knit. Or you can just go out on the streets of San Myshuno and bring your sales table there and just sell it out on the street. Another role play idea is you could create onesies for babies in need, and you can donate them. I love with my Sims who knit, I love making them like little craft rooms with the build items. And if you have seasons, you can always gift your creations to family or friends. And the last and most recent pack as of today is Paranormal. Now, I don't know a lot about the pack. I haven't played much of it, but I kind of had the idea that you could create like a Ghostbusters group or like a club for psychic mediums and just bond over that, I guess, and obviously become a freelance medium and get rid of some ghosts. Okay. Oh my God. That was a lot. That was a mouthful. I did not enjoy talking about my first pet stuff. It's a little traumatic. I'll be fine. But thank you guys so much for watching. Making this list really gave me a lot of ideas that I never even thought about. So let me know what you guys think, and if you try them out, how well it goes. If you like the video, don't forget to leave it a like, and as always, don't forget to subscribe for more videos just like this. I'll see y'all later. Bye.